just want to do a quick video of everything I have going on right now, as far as live birds. These are the quail that I hatched, I want to say, 2 weeks ago, and they are already huge. They are fully feathered. I haven't had them under, well, they're not fully feathered, but they're getting there. But I haven't had them under a heat lamp in, dang, I want to say almost maybe 4 days now. And they are thriving. They are doing good. These here are the Buff Orpingtons. I bought these from Tractor Supply. I actually bought 4 of them, but I gave 2 of them to my sister. I clean their water out. They keep kicking their stuff around. But yeah, what she get? This one right here. That's Baby. And the other one is Shy. But Baby, her first 24 hours here, I mean, they were terrible. My niece was playing with them. She accidentally dropped her. And she hurt her leg, so she was limping for like, dang, I want to say a couple of hours. But I let her walk around on the hardwood floor. And she recovered kind of quickly. So she's not hurt anymore. Then yesterday, what happened? Their water, I accidentally knocked over their water. And I didn't think a lot of water, you know, got in until I looked over and saw a Baby, like, moving around a lot, like, not being herself. So I looked at her, I said, is she wet? So I looked at her and I seen how much, you know, water was in their bin. And put her in front of the space heater, got her dried off. She's doing good. I'm going to have to keep an eye on Baby because so far, she done had a pretty rough start with us. So, you know, I'm going to have to be real careful with her. Oh, my quail. These are also the meat birds. So, I'm going to use them as for meat and eggs. So, and I honestly believe I have all females here. I honestly believe I have all females. So, hopefully, when this next batch hatch, I get a male. But I seriously think those are all female, which is terrible if you're trying to, you know, keep the chain going, supply food going. But these are my other meat birds. These are Cornish Cross. I purchased these from Tractor Co. I mean, I keep saying Tractor Co., Tractor Supply. Like, 2 days after I got the Buff Orpingtons, I wanted to wait to get started on these, but I decided to just go ahead and jump into it. And, you know, I've been trying to prepare myself, you know, for a processing day. And the same with the quail, you know, I decided to go ahead and jump into it. But these birds will be ready for processing in 8 weeks. So, they eat a lot. They eat a whole lot. And I'm like, dang, I had to go out and buy more food today because I did not expect these little babies to eat so much, but they do. But all these birds, well, it's winter here where I'm at. And I want to get the birds and the quail set up outside eventually, you know, when it get warmed up and I can go ahead and build a chicken coop. And I'm going to call it a quail resort because I thought about I was looking at the cages, you know, and I'm like, dang, I don't think it's right. You know, I just didn't think it's right, you know, for me to keep them in cages, you know, until I process them. You know, I just had a hard time. You know, I want them to enjoy their life, you know. And that one actually might be a male. I'm going to have to wait till next week. I think I got a male in there, that big one. But, yeah, I want them to enjoy their life as the best they can, you know, as much as they can. And, you know, I want to have something better to offer them besides, you know, just keeping them in a cage. I want them to live a full, happy life. So, I've been looking around online for some ideas, and I seen the quite a few quail, what they call them? I can't think of the word right now. But anyway, quail houses and whatever that's kind of caged in so they can have some freedom, because I don't want these walking around on wire at all. Like, I just don't feel that's right. But to each their own, right? I'm not judging nobody. It's just not something that, you know, I want to do for my birds. You know, so, I mean, I just want them to have a happy life and not live their life in a small cage. So, yeah, when it gets warmed up, I'm actually, these first birds here, I'm not going to process these at all. Like, this is my first time ever hatching eggs or, you know, anything like this. This is my first project. So, I'm going to put a bracelet around them, you know, on their ankles. So, I know not to process them. I'm keeping them until they die naturally, you know. But, yeah, so hopefully I get the, get everything set up outside. I can't wait for it to get warm because, you know, I'm starting to get ideas. I got a lot of wood and pallets in my backyard already, so I'm just going to reuse a lot of the wood that I already have around the house. And been looking at ideas for chicken coops and also ideas to have them outside, you know, because I don't want to raise animals in my house. I got two dogs in my house, and little do they know, they will be going outside too. So, yeah, but I'm excited about this. You know, I'm still kind of nervous and still trying to figure out how I'm going to get my thoughts together to kill these little babies because they're so cute and fluffy. I mean, they are so cute and fluffy. But, yeah, that's just my quick review. Yeah, I'm recording you and I'm talking about y'all. You know, and actually, in the future, I won't do it now, but I also been thinking about keeping a rooster for these. They have these no-crow collars. So, because I'm not allowed to have a rooster, you know, in the city where I live, you know, so they say no loud roosters, honestly. So, thinking about, I'm going to keep a rooster. I'm not going to do it now, though, but keep a rooster and keep at least four hens back, you know, so I can, they can lay eggs for me and I can hatch out the Cornish cross myself now. Study says that can't be done, but of course people on YouTube gotta test that theory, and they hatch their own meat birds, you know, because they say Cornish cross get so big they can't walk and stuff like that. They have to be artificially inseminated and stuff like that. So yeah, quite a few people on YouTube test that theory, and they found it to be false. So I will be holding back a rooster and four hens in the future. Matter of fact, I think I'm going to go back to Tractor Supply next weekend and buy four more and let those be the hens, you know, that I keep. Because it take about 6 months, 5 or 6 months for these girls to actually start laying, and I can get my rooster probably a month and a half before, you know, they start laying, so I can hurry up and collect the eggs and stuff like that, you know, and incubate them. So, yeah, this is my project. I'm excited about it, nervous at the same time. You know, sometimes I ask myself, what are you doing, girl? But, you know, yeah, so that's my quick little update and my little projects I got going on. Also, I did not use a heat lamp. I had ordered these pendant lights from Amazon a couple of months ago, way before I had the idea of growing my own meats and vegetables. And what I did was, these lights right here, they came from Dollar Tree. One was $1.25, but when I went back to get another one, because, you know, the Cornish hen, they came second. But they was marked down to 25 cents. So I had to grab me a whole bunch of them. But this is what I have been using to help them stay warm. And, you know, in my opinion, it's a lot more safe than using a heat lamp. I mean, a heat light. So, it's been working out great. If it gets too hot right there, they know how to move around, you know, get out from under that heat. You know, they ain't crazy. So, yeah, I did the same thing with the quail. So, yeah, I'll be posting more videos soon. Just be looking out. Be blessed.